Education Society, redefining excellence.
Welcome back. In the previous 2-3 classes, we have obtained the state models from the transfer function. And those were obtained in different forms, such as controllable canonical form, observable canonical form, or diagonal Jordan canonical form. Now, at the end, we discussed that is it possible to convert the state model into transfer function? If it is so, then how? So let us, in this lecture, we will see how a state model can be converted into transfer function. We'll develop the formula for that. Conversion of state model into transfer function. So what we will do, we will consider a state model represented by x dot t is equal to a x of t plus b u of t. This is the state equation, and output equation is y of t is equal to c x of t plus d u of t. And the transfer function is given by Laplace transform output by Laplace transform input with zero initial conditions, that is y of s by u of s with zero initial conditions. So now if I take Laplace of this, I will get y of s is equal to c x of s plus d u of s. But I cannot take the ratio of y by u because x of s is also there, which I need to eliminate. Then how to do it? If I take Laplace of this and Laplace transform the equation number, let us give the numbers, let this be equation 1, let this be equation 2. So if I take Laplace transform equation 1, I will get the relation between x of s and u of s. And that relation, if I substitute here, I can eliminate the term x of s. So let us do it. So taking Laplace transform on both sides of equation 1, we get s x of s minus x of 0 is equal to a x of s plus b u of s. It is a differential equation. So by using the differentiation in time domain property of Laplace transform, we have obtained this. And now already we know that in the definition of transfer function, it is said that neglecting initial conditions or initial conditions to be zero. So we will also neglect this initial condition, neglecting initial condition, we get s x of s is equal to a x of s plus b u of s. So if I take it that s x of s minus a of s, and then x of s is post multiplied, so it can be taken common. So it will be s minus a, but s is a variable and a is a matrix. So instead of s, we have to make it si, where I is the identity matrix of same size of the size of a. So what I will get here, si minus a matrix post multiplied with x of s is equal to b u of s. And now if I want the term for x of s, then pre-multiply. On both sides. With si minus a inverse. So if I multiply here, pre-multiply here si minus a inverse, si minus a inverse into si minus a will become my I matrix, identity matrix. So it will be x of s. And that will be equal to si minus a inverse b u of s. So let us just mark this as 3. And now, taking Laplace transform of equation 2, we get y of s is equal to c x of s plus d u of s. And then from 3, if I put the value of x of s here, what I get? So I write here combining two and three, y of s is equal to c into si minus a inverse b u of s. Instead of x of s, we put si minus a inverse b u of s plus d u of s, and which gives me as c into si minus a inverse b plus d whole multiplied with u of s. And hence g of s, that is transfer function or transfer function matrix in case of multiple input multiple output system, is obtained by c into si minus a inverse b plus d. So this is the formula. So I can write here that equation 4 is the formula for converting state model into transfer function. Very clear. So formula is obtained. What we will do to realize it, we will solve a numerical example. Meanwhile, you can revise these steps. We will take the example as, let we have the state model x dot is equal to 0, 1, minus 4, minus 7, x plus 0, 1, u, and y is equal to 1, 3, x. So in this case, what I get? What we have to do? Determine transfer function of the given state model. And the solution is, what we do have now in this particular example? So this is A matrix. X dot is equal to AX plus BU, Y is equal to CX. So D is 0, but this is A, B and C. They are available. So I will do, I have a formula, G of S, that is transfer function, equal to C into SI minus A inverse B plus D. So what are the steps? First we have to find out SI minus A, then we have to find out its inverse, then pre-multiplied with C, post-multiplied with B, and then add D. So let's start with here. We have A is equal to 0, 1, minus 4, minus 7. And this gives me SI minus A equal to SI minus A equal to, in the first example I will show you how to write SI, S into I is 1, 0, 0, 1. Minus 0, 1, minus 4, minus 7, and that will be equal to S 0, 0, yeah. So this is a scalar. We have to multiply every element with it. Minus 0, 1, minus 4, minus 7. And that will be equal to, I will make it here, s minus 0 is s, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, 0 minus minus 4 is 4, and s minus minus 7 is s plus 7. So this is done. And now what we will do, we will find out si minus a inverse by adjoint method. And for 2 by 2, it can be done directly. Here I presume that you know how to find out inverse of a matrix. So this will be s plus 7, 1, minus 4, s. For 2 by 2 matrix, it is interchange these two elements and change the sign of this element and sign of this element and divided by its determinant, that is s square plus 7s plus 4. And now what is g of s? G of s is c into si minus a inverse b plus d. So let us do it. What is c we have? C is 1, 3. What is si minus a inverse we have obtained? S plus 7, 1, minus 4, s whole divided by s square plus 7s plus 4 into here b is 0, 1 and plus d is 0. So it will be same as this. And then if I solve this, so I will do this calculation first. So it will be 1, 3 into this will be 0 plus 1 is 1. And this will be 0 plus s will be s and whole divided by s square plus 7s plus 4. And now do it. It is 3s plus 1 divided by s square plus 7s plus 4. It is done. This is a transfer function obtained for the given state model. And if you look at the state model clearly, it is in the controllable canonical form. Now look at the transfer function. From this you try to get it. See, in controllable canonical form, first two elements will be 0, 1, then minus 4, minus 7, b is 0, 1, and c is 1, 3. This is done. So just for cross verification. And now what we will do, we will solve one or two more examples. And that will clarify the concept. Let us consider another example to find out the transfer function from the state model. Let x dot is equal to say 0, 1, minus 2, minus 5, x plus 1, 0, 1, 1, u. And y is equal to 1, 1, 1, 0, x. And what you have to do? Determine transfer function. Now you look at the state model. You may find that A is a 2 by 2 matrix. That means it is a second order system. B is also a 2 by 2 matrix. What it indicates? It indicates that there are two inputs, u1 and u2. Column 1 related to u1, column 2 related to u2. And then y is a 2 by 2 matrix. That means it consists of two outputs, y1 and y2. This first row corresponding to y1, second row corresponding to y2. That means there are two inputs and two outputs. So in this case, we must get four transfer functions. G11 will be equal to y1 by u1, g12 will be y1 by u2, g21 will be y2 by u1, and g22 will be y2 by u2. And they all will come in a matrix, and here the transfer function will become transfer function matrix. Let us see how it happens. So here our A is 0, 1, minus 2, minus 5, and then SI minus A. Now I will write it directly, S minus 1, 2, S plus 5, then its inverse the determinant is S square plus 5S plus 2, and the elements will be these two interchanging, so S plus 5 S, and change the sign of minus 1 to 1, change the sign of 2 to minus 2, and this is what, this is SI minus A inverse. So this is also obtained. Now we have a formula, G of S is equal to C into SI minus A inverse B plus D. Even here we have D equal to 0, but it will remain in the formula. So it will be, what is C matrix? Our C matrix is 1, 1, 1, 0. SI minus A inverse is S plus 5, 1, minus 2, S. Its determinant is S square plus 5S plus 2. And B matrix is 1, 1, 0, 1, column wise. And now, let us have this multiplication. So S plus 5 minus 2 is S plus 3, 1 plus S, I will write this as S plus 1, S plus 5 plus 0 is S plus 5, and again this will be 1 plus 0, this is 1, and this will get multiplied with 1, 0, 1, 1. And so then the transfer function G of S will be, see this multiplication, S plus 3 plus S plus 1, so it's 2S plus 4, then it's 0 plus S plus 1, so this will be S plus 1, then this will be S plus 5 plus 1, this is S plus 6. And finally 0 plus 1, so this would be 1. This is divided by S square plus 5S plus 2. And this we can write as (2S plus 4 divided by S square plus 5S plus 2) S plus 1 divided by S square plus 5S plus 2, S plus 6 divided by S square plus 5S plus 2, and 1 upon S square plus 5S plus 2. So as we discussed earlier, it's a transfer function matrix with 4 transfer functions, where this is relating Y1 and u1, this is relating y1 and u2, so this is y1 of s by u1 of s, this is y1 of s by u2 of s, this is y2 of s by u1 of s, and this is y2 of s by u2 of s. So if you want to get y1, it will be this transfer function into u1 of s plus this transfer function into u2 of s, that will be y of s, and then you have to take Laplace transform, a Laplace inverse. That is why I said in the first lecture that the treatment in the transfer function approach requires more calculations than this. This is the easier. See, these 4 transfer functions are just represented by a state model. Done. Now, what we will do, we will take one more example, and the example is a little bit interesting, and you will find that it is interesting at the end of the results. So, let x dot is equal to say minus 1, 0, minus 2, 3, x plus 1, 0, 0, 1, u, and y is 1, 0, x. And we have, what we have to do? We have to determine transfer function. And see, now the solution, let us start solving. What we have? A, B, C. D is 0, but here in B there are two columns, so there are two inputs, and output is only 1. So this one output can be obtained by the contribution of two inputs. Correct? Let us see what happens. So here we have A is equal to minus 1, 0, minus 2, 3. And that means SI minus A is equal to S plus 1, 0, 2, S minus 3. Directly done. And then SI minus A inverse will be equal to S minus 3, 0, minus 2, S plus 1 divided by, we can directly write S plus 1 into S minus 3 without any expansion. It doesn't make any difference. Okay. So this is SI minus A inverse, and then transfer function G of S is equal to C into SI minus A inverse B plus D. In our case, it will be our C matrix is one zero, then SI minus A inverse is S minus 3, 0, minus 2, S plus 1, whole divided by S plus 1 into S minus 3, and again multiplication with matrix P is 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. So now what we will do, we will perform these calculations. And or even here it is possible, and this is equal to, so this will be, this is identity matrix actually, so this multiplied with this will be the same. Okay, we will get it directly. So 1 into S minus 3 is S minus 3, S minus 3 plus 0 is S minus 3. And then second thing, 0 plus 0 is 0. And this multiplied with 1, 0, 0, 1, and whole divided by, it is S plus 1 into S minus 3. Correct? And now, this is nothing but G of S equal to S minus 3 and then 0 whole divided by S plus 1 into S minus 3, and it is having two transfer functions. This will be y1 by u1, this will be y1 by u2, as there is only one input. But what we can see, this 0 shows that there is no impact of the second input on the output, but still the input is there, and it doesn't have any sense in the contribution to the output signal y. Also, what we can see, now this can be written as S minus 3 upon S plus 1 into S minus 3 and 0, and there is cancellation, pole 0 cancellation, s minus 3 is getting cancelled with s minus 3, and then it is 1 upon s plus 1 0. Then in that case the system y1 by u1 is of first order, but we have obtained the state matrix as 2 by 2, or that system matrix, and there are two states chosen. So this is not a minimal realization. Now recall the definition of state, that we have to select the minimum number of state variables, which is not done here. So always, if you have a transfer function, if you want to realize its state model, then first you have to check for pole zero cancellations, perform the pole zero cancellations, and then on the remaining part you have to go for the conversion to state model. This is not done in this particular numerical, and that is why you are getting like this. So purposely I have taken this example. Now what we will do, we will extend our scope to a 3 by 3 system or a third order system. Let us solve one more example. And let us take again a very simple example for calculations, and that will be, say, x dot is equal to 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 3, minus 2, minus 5, x plus 0, 0, 1, u, and y is equal to 1, minus 1, 0, x. Now actually this is in a controllable canonical form, and from this directly you can get the answer without having any calculation. If it is in controllable canonical form, only then. So we will get the answer and then we will discuss how it was possible. What we have to do? We have to determine transfer function. So what is A here? A is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 3, minus 2, minus 5, and then SI minus A will be S minus 1, 0, 0, S minus 1, 3, 2, S plus 5. And now let us find out its inverse by adjoint method. So for this particular element it will be S square plus 5S plus 2. Then for this element 0 plus 3, but as this element is in the second, first row second column, this will be 0 minus minus plus 3, so it will be minus 3. Then for this element 0 minus 3s, so it is minus 3s. So this I am doing that you already know how to find out inverse by adjoint method. Then for this element it will be s minus 5, but as this is s plus 5, it will be s plus 5. Then for this one it will be s square plus 5s minus 0, so s square plus 5s. Then for this one it will be 2s plus 3, so I have to write minus 2s minus 3, because I have to multiply that by minus 1. And then the last one, this will be 1, for this it will be s, and for this it will be s square, and divided by its determinant. Its determinant is s into s square plus 5s plus 2, that is s cube plus 5s square plus 2s, and then for this it is plus 1 into 3. So plus 3, this is the determinant. You can solve it separately. And now once we have this, then g of s is equal to what? C. What is C here? 1 minus 1, 0. Then SI minus A inverse is, we will copy it here, and B is 0, 0, 1 and whole divided by S square plus 5 S cube plus 5 S square plus 2 S plus 3, and then that is equal to 1 minus 1 0 into, I will do this calculation, 0 plus 0 plus 1, this is 1, then 0 plus 0 plus this is S, 0 plus 0 plus this S square, whole divided by S cube plus 5 S square plus 2 S plus 3, and that you will get as 1 minus S. So minus S plus 1 plus 0 S square divided by S cube plus 5 S square plus 2 S plus 3. And now see, these are the elements of denominator in the reverse order, 3, 2s, 5 s square and s cube. Recall the concept of controllable canonical state space representation, and numerator again in the reverse order. So this will be 1, this will be minus s. It was possible directly, but that is possible in controllable canonical form and observable canonical form only, otherwise not. Now what we will do, we will take another example with inclusion of D matrix. So let this be X dot is equal to say 0, 1, minus 4, minus 6, X plus 2, 1, U, Y is equal to 0, 1, X plus U. This example we will take. And what we have to do? Same. We have to determine transfer function, and we start with the solution now. So what we have? We have A matrix is 0, minus 4, 1, minus 6, and that gives me SI minus A equal to S 4 minus 1 S plus 6, and then its inverse will be 6 minus 4 1 S divided by S square plus 6 S plus 4, and then let us use the formula. So here we have G of S is equal to, now we will not write the formula, we directly start writing the matrices 0, 1, S plus 6 minus 4, 1, S, 2, 1 divided by S square plus 6, S plus 4. And then it is nothing but equal to 0, 1, this is 1, 0, 1, this is S, again 2, 1 divided by S square plus, and plus 1 is also there, plus D, this D is 1, this one. 6s plus 4 plus 1, so this will be, now do this multiplication, this is 2 plus s, so I will write this as s plus 2, upon s square plus 6s plus 4 plus 1. And now what is it? it is equal to s plus 2 plus s square plus 6s plus 4 divided by s square plus 6s plus 4. So what is the final answer? Final answer is g of s equal to, this will be s square plus 6 plus 1 7s plus 4 plus 2 is 6 divided by s square plus 6s plus 4. Done. So we have solved examples on this and the concept is well percolated. Now the thing is that we have seen how to convert the state transfer function into state model or into different state kind of state models, that is controllable canonical, observable canonical, or same are called as phase variable forms, and also the canonical forms like diagonal canonical and Jordan canonical. Later we have seen that if the state model is given, how to convert it into transfer function. So in the next lecture what we will do, we will see that if we have a state model in one form, how to transform it into other form. Thank you.